stealing began. Land, cattle, horses, everything began to disappear. There's a saying that men will steal everything but a milestone and a millstone. They stole my millstones. John Augustus Sutter.
Born on February 15, 1803, in Kandern, Germany, Johann Augustus Sutter was the son of Johann Jacob Sutter, a humble and hardworking foreman in a paper mill. After leaving the military academy he attended in Switzerland, he married the daughter of a rich widow, Annette de Belde. Sutter engaged in many business ventures, such as a dry goods firm in Bergdorf. However, they would all end in failure, as he consistently showed more interest in spending money than earning it. When authorities approached Sutter regarding his growing debts, they told him that unless the money was paid back, he would be sent to prison. To avoid these consequences, Johann changed his name to John Sutter and left Switzerland to pursue his economic dreams in the promised land of America, leaving behind his wife and 5 children.
After many more unsuccessful ventures throughout the entirety of the U.S., from St. Louis to Oregon, Sutter eventually found himself in Northern California. It was here that he finally caught his big break, which came in the form of persuading Mexican governor Juan Bautista de Alvarado to grant him a large reservation of land. Sutter told Alvarado that he wanted to build a lively fort and trading post at the foot of the Sierra Nevada Mountains, inland from present-day San Francisco. The Mexican governor, believing that Mexico would benefit greatly from a thriving community in the midst of the undeveloped valley, was enthusiastic about Sutter's plans. He proposed that Sutter could become a Mexican citizen and the legal owner of a vast tract of land if he developed the land within a year. Sutter was thus granted 50,000 acres near the Sacramento River. There was just one problem, though. An estimated 300,000 Native Americans already called that area home. In his eyes, though, these individuals were just a large obstacle standing in the way of his entitled success.
John Sutter immediately set out to build his fort, which he decided would be named New Helvetia, or New Switzerland. He couldn't tackle it alone, however, so he formulated a system of slave labor exploiting the local Nisenan Maidu and Miwok tribes. This included directing the actual construction of his trading post, as well as training a makeshift militia from the ground up to protect his land from any hostile attacks from other neighboring Indian tribes. The Native Americans were forced into a life of indentured servitude that included planting wheat, raising cattle, barreling salmon and meat for trade, trapping beavers, and distilling brandy. Sutter was also known to be very fond of the young Indian women, some of whom even bore his children. In all aspects, he consistently took advantage of the Indians for his own personal gain.
At first, it seemed as if Sutter's venture was destined for tremendous success. His holdings were estimated at approximately 12,000 cattle, 2,000 horses, and more than 10,000 sheep. He also held the post of Indian sub-agent for the tribes in the Sacramento area, and his hospitable treatment of Western travelers encouraged further pioneer migration from the East. However, all this changed when James Marshall, an architect he had hired to scope out the land of his new mill, noticed nuggets of gold sparkling on the bed of the American River. Sutter and Marshall knew the importance of keeping this discovery under wraps. They urged their Indian workers to keep their sighting a secret. Quickly, though, word got out. Many historians believe that the resentment held by Indians at the fort towards Sutter and his immoral rule contributed to this leak of information. It didn't take long for the exciting news to spread around the U.S., spurring the famed California Gold Rush of 1848.
For most, the idea of unearthing gold on one's property would be a dream. For John Sutter, New Helvetia, and his native workers, however, it proved to be a nightmare. Prospective 49ers from all around the world flocked to John Sutter's mill and overran his property in search of gold. All of the Indian workers were murdered or driven out of their land, which nearly led to the complete destruction of the Indian population in the region. The 49ers plundered all of Sutter's land and even challenged his property claims themselves. Forced into lengthy and expensive court battles, Sutter eventually had no choice but to sell all of his land. John Sutter, once one of the most powerful men in California, was now bankrupt. He spent the rest of his life lobbying the California government for compensation for his losses until his death in 1880. It may never be known exactly how James Marshall's discovery of gold in Sutter's mill was spread around to the whole world. However, John Sutter's exploitation of Native American tribes like the Miwok and Nisenan Maidu will forever leave a mark on the legend of John Sutter.